And curiously enough, we just happened to have both of those players here in the studio this afternoon. Dunfermline striker Andy Smith and alongside Andy, the now Raith Rovers midfielder Kenny Black. We'll hear from both players in a moment, but let's see the best of that game at Starks Park between Raith and Dunfermline. John McVeigh's outfit determined to make amends for two defeats in 7 days. Everything was rosy enough up until last weekend, 9 goals in 2 games before that. Then a 2-0 defeat by Morton, followed by Tuesday's 3-1 Challenge Cup defeat by Livingston. Not the best build-up to the first Fife derby since both clubs were in the Premier League in 1997. David McKinney has all the action.
Just over 7,000, the largest crowd of the day in Division 1 was at Starks Park for the Fife derby. This is the man the Raith fans came to see, Didier Agathy. But it was first blood to Dunfermline, with Brian Reid involved twice. It's his header from Stuart Petrie's free kick, and the big defender puts in a determined challenge for his second goal of the season. And there's no mistaking what it means to him, as well as his teammates. David Moss and Andy Smith both involved. The long leg of Reid makes contact, and that's a sickener for the Raith management team of John McVeigh and Peter Heatherston. And it threatened to get worse. Once again, the Raith defence failed to clear the lines. Guido van de Kamp, villain, then hero in the space of a couple of seconds. And Scott Thompson unable to make the home side pay. But enough of the fancy stuff. Route 1 can be just as effective, especially when you have the height of Andy Smith and the perception of Owen Coyle. David Moss bringing out the best in Van de Kamp. Moss is still to score for Dunfermline since coming from Falkirk, denied by the Dutchman. It wasn't all one-way traffic. Dunfermline's veteran keeper Ian Westwater matched his opposite number to push away a Kenny Black effort. Black never afraid to shoot from distance, and that's a fine save. We've already seen the aerial presence of Andy Smith, and the big man has a knack of being in the right place at the right time, although it's fair to say his goals aren't always pretty. And when Scott Thompson's cross comes in, it's Smith on hand to bundle the ball into the net. It's Big Andy's fifth of the season, and he might not get many marks for style or artistic impression, but he's there to direct the ball into the net. And that should have been that for Dunfermline at this stage, and a away win looked a certainty, especially when the Powers threatened to increase their lead. David Moss and then Thompson denied by more heroics from Van de Kamp. The big keeper has had his critics, but that's a great save and a vital one. Its importance became clearer just 7 minutes later as Rovers fought back into the game. Jay Steen with a nimble footwork on the left, Craig Dargo supplying the finish. The striker might not have been at Starks Park, with Morton tabling a £100,000 bid for his services earlier this week. That offer was turned down, and I'm sure the Raith fans are thankful for it. And it's not hard to see why Dargo's in demand. He leads the division's scoring charge with Owen Coyle, and his seventh of the season came from Agathy's cross. The under-21 striker with a brave header under pressure, and it's an unlikely point for Rovers.
Yeah, the game ended a 2-2 draw at Starks Park, and after the match, Football First Dean Adamson spoke to both managers.
Yeah, it was a very good comeback. The one thing, we're never down and out. You know, that's been preached to the lads. But I'm very, very disappointed that we didn't take all 3 points, because I thought we were more than worthy of the 3 points.
Yeah, she would consider that 2 points down, although you did come back from 2 goals down. The second half performance was tremendous.
Yeah, we did come back from 2 goals down. We showed a lot of character. Again, it was sloppy defending and silly mistakes that cost us. But at the end of the day, every time we went forward in the second half, we looked to have a cutting edge about us. And their attacks were very, very limited and few and far between.
I think John McVeigh will be a little happier than I am. You know, I felt in the game that for 60 minutes, Raith Rovers never...